Curtis. It's me, Old School.
And Rocco.
And we are here in Pittsburgh about to go into the Victory Point Gaming Cafe, where guess what they have? Actual Japanese sit-down cabinets, man!
You don't say.
Have you ever played an actual Japanese sit-down arcade cabinet? Well, you about to...
Discovered Fist of the North Star. I just got done finishing the first round, and the buttons are so responsive. I'm starting to like this a lot more in comparison to a lot of like the American-made arcade cabinets.
This place might not be the biggest arcade I've ever been in, but I'll tell you, between having some awesome Japanese cabinets and one of my favorite motion games of all time, Crazy Taxi, I gotta say I'm having a good time so far. It's a lot looser than I remember it being.
Come on. There we go.
Give me that money. Give me that money.
Who's trying to get smoked? Dude, I have no idea what's happening right now, but I love it.
There's so much happening all at once.
Wait, do I have to hold now?
We are about to play some Battletoads, dude. Dude, I was never really a big fan of Battletoads, like on the NES series, man, because I was a big fan of NES. To begin with, I mean, it was
right.
God, I know, put your hate comments below, man. But I did grow to really like Battletoads over time.
Yeah. I mean, the last time I played Battletoads, it was either on PC or PlayStation 1. It was like one of the two.
Mega Man, the Japanese fighting game.
I like them a lot better than the American ones, I'm gonna tell you that. Mainly because of just how responsive they are, like the buttons and joysticks are, on top of just the graphics of them. Like, mm-hmm. They look great. All
they're sturdy, they're sound, you can load a ton of games into them, man.
For sure.
Now I said it 1,000 times, man. I hate Transformers movies, but what I do like is Transformer games based on the movies, dude. Here's one of my favorites. I played this Transformers sitting Autobot game 1,000 times over, dude. But now Rocco's gonna get a chance to play it. So what do you think of these like modern like quarter munching shooters, man?
They are a lot of fun. Yeah, let me shoot you in the face. Wow, that took so much of my health.
Oh, snap!
The big man himself!
So to kick this review into gear though, man, this is a smaller place. It's not big, and honestly, there was only 2 new games that I saw from the last time I was in there a couple years ago, man. But this is a unique place, wouldn't you say?
It absolutely
has something special and different away from the norm with all those Japanese games.
Yeah, no, that was the thing that stood out from all of the other arcades we've ever been to.
I mean, I would call this place a deep gamer hidden gem. Import gaming.
Yep.
I mean, this is something that doesn't seem to get talked about very much in YouTube online gaming shows. And they should, because these games are off the chain,
yeah,
right?
No, these games are kick ass, dude.
They were just balls to the wall, crazy colored shooters, ridiculously cute chibis, just absolutely insane full roaming gun battle stuff.
But it all looks so gorgeous though, which is so different.
It really does. Now this is the hard part, trying to give this place a review, man, because it is small, dude. The staff is nice. I'm gonna say based on solely its different aspects, the things that make it stand out, I'm gonna say B+.
Yeah.
It's bold. B+.
B+.
If you call yourself a tried and true gamer, and you are a gamer, you need to go. So we're going to end it on that, man. So until next time, my name is Old School.
And I'm Rocco.
And this was One Button Joystick. And now, a very special announcement from the creator of One Button Joystick, which is me, Old School. The thing is, all four episodes in the past month were filmed in the very final week of February, and in the time between post-production and when we started to upload them back in April, a lot of things changed. Unfortunately, man, Full Blast Arcade and Amusement, featured heavily in last week's episode of the Ohio Arcades, has permanently closed. Our hearts go out to the owner of that shop and wish him only the best of luck, and we also wish only the best of luck and safety to everybody out there in general. So in the past month, we've been getting a ton of new subscribers and love, man, we'll be getting some questions about certain things, like where can people find all of our past episodes. So currently, the only place you can actually watch the first four episodes of One Button Joystick is on our Facebook page, One Button Joystick. Go to the videos, scroll all the way back down to the first three or four, man, and that's season one that were filmed in late 2016 and 2017. Season two is on a playlist on our High Evolution Studios YouTube page, man. So just go to the playlist, you can watch all nine episodes of that. Season three started late last year and is running into this year, and unfortunately because of this coronavirus situation, we have no more arcades to review because they're all closed, and we'll be coming back with more action.